circumstances. As you begin to confess the Lordship of Jesus in faith, His rule enters that settings and that circumstances. I hope you catch this, because it's very important. I want to read this again. Because I kept saying it again and again, I began to know what God was trying to tell me. He said, as we declare the Lordship of Jesus Christ in faith, His rule enters those settings and circumstances. So whatever setting is there, whatever circumstance is there, if you begin to declare the Lordship of Jesus Christ in faith, He comes and rules.
Man.
He comes and rules. I declare the Lordship of Jesus Christ over Harvest Revival Center. I declare the Lordship of Jesus Christ over the leadership of Harvest Revival Center. I declare the Lordship of Jesus Christ over every ministry in Harvest Revival Center. You know, as I do that in faith, the sovereign rule of our Lord, the sovereign rule of our God, enters to take charge of Harvest Revival Center. The sovereign rule of God enters to take charge of Harvest Revival Center, take charge of the leadership, take charge of the ministry. What did I do? I just proclaimed the Lordship of Jesus Christ over the church. You can proclaim the Lordship of Jesus Christ in your families. Some of your families are going through so much trouble and difficult situations. You proclaim the Lordship of Jesus Christ over your family. I tell you, the rule of the sovereign God enters into your situation and takes control. Somebody say amen to that if you believe it.
Amen.
Finally, friends, when you have faith vision, you confess faith. You confess faith, that's faith confession. Alright? If you have faith vision and you're already declaring faith confession, there must be a faith action. Faith action. Everybody say faith action.
Faith action.
There must be a faith action. If you have faith vision, you have faith confession, faith and action. Now is a faith action.
Faith action.
Without when you have faith, if you don't let your faith work, you don't see the manifestation of the faith. You have to work it out. You've got to work it out. Alright? Your action has got to come into your faith. Faith without works is dead, the Bible says. Faith without works. Okay? And God is speaking, God is speaking to us, friends, that we need to come to a place where we receive the word, receive the faith vision, begin to confess the word, and take action. You know, God is seeking people who will not only hear His words. All of you come, you come to me here. You are coming and hearing the word of God and you go. God is seeking people who will not only hear the word, but will take them into heart. Take them into heart and act on them. So every Sunday, if you are here and you are listening to the word of God, whoever Rocky is preaching, doesn't matter. But if you are taking the word is God, the power of God, the word of God is the Lord Jesus Christ Himself. And the word became flesh, Jesus Christ, right? So when you begin to receive that word, and you take that word into heart and act on them, there is no way you will say, here I am not growing. I am not growing. Sorry, Pastor, I tell you, I'm not growing in this church. Have you heard that? Very familiar? But I want to tell you, growth is our personal life. If I want to grow, I will grow. I will read the word, I will fast and pray, I will grow. I will receive the word of God. So when you receive the word of God, take it to heart and act on that word, you will definitely grow. You will definitely grow. No way that you say, oh, I'm not growing. Growth is you and God. Receive the word. Take it to heart and apply the word in your heart. You will grow. Doing what you believe and confess. Acting on that, right? Doing what you believe and confess. Applying God's word in your life. Applying. How many of us just suddenly we can't hear the word and throughout the week we've forgotten everything that we have heard? We didn't apply the word? So when the word is not applied in your life, how can you grow? When the word is not applied in your life, you won't grow. Alright? Give thanks in faith. You need to thank God in faith. Alright, as you do that, we need to realize that God is doing something and by faith you're thanking Him. So friends, I'm going to just close in 5 minutes. I just want to share in my heart and say, if you are really believing God for a financial breakthrough,
Yes.
Now, I can talk about financial breakthroughs because if you are in a difficult financial situation, I have been there before. You say, cannot be. How can doctor? How can be? But I want to tell you, I have been in situations where I have had financial problems, financial difficulties, and I tell you, friends, I'm not ashamed to tell you that the repossession guards came to my clinic to possess my car about 10 years ago. I'm not ashamed to tell you that I have a difficult financial situation. We go through that situation. Because we have gone through, I can preach with such confidence. If you are believing God for a financial breakthrough, visualize the Lord, our provider, with a faith vision. With a faith vision. Jehovah Jireh. With a faith vision, begin to visualize. In faith confession, declare, my God shall supply all my need according to his riches in glory. Begin to declare. Then you are finding difficulty in your situations. Declare, my God shall supply all my need according to his riches. And then, what do you do in faith action? I told you faith vision, faith confession, you're saying, my God shall supply all my need. What is the faith action that you're going to do? The faith action is, sow whatever you have as a seed. Sow whatever you have as a seed. Sow whatever you have as a seed, invest into the kingdom of God and reap what you sow. That is faith action. You have faith, visualizing faith vision. You declare, my God shall supply all my need. Now it's faith action. Sow into the kingdom of God. Sow what the little that you have as a seed. And the seed of faith will grow. Last Sunday, our brother Pasu gave us a testimony. Without your permission, I'm going to tell them they don't care. All right. Now, he began to listen to all these messages about sowing into the kingdom, give unto God, and all these things. And it seems he gave a small amount towards the kingdom of God. And last week, he came to find out he got a 100-fold investment come through, a deep come through. Isn't that God? Come on. Yeah. Come on, give God glory. Yes. God. He just said the seed of faith was just a small one. But he got a big deal. Because God knows how to bless his servants. If you know what it means to have faith vision, faith confession, and faith action, he took action in his faith. And that's why he saw the income. Said one more, if you believe in God for a healing, visualize with the eyes of faith. See the Lord, Jehovah Rapha, the Lord, your healer, making you whole. When I pray for my patients in the clinic, I always will say one statement. It has become part of my statement when I pray in the clinic. Lord, I proclaim your name as Jehovah Rapha. I always say this statement when I pray for my patients in the clinic. You know why I'm doing that? When I started out doing it, I didn't know why I was doing it. Now I know. I was declaring in faith confession. Lord, heal this man. Lord, reveal himself. Reveal yourself to him, Lord, and show him, Lord, you are Jehovah Rapha, our healer.
Yes.
Whenever I pray for my patient, I say that. Jehovah Rapha some guys come to ask me, but what is that Rapha? Your wife's name? Somebody asked me, oh, your daughter's name? My daughter's name? No, I said, no, this is a Hebrew name, original word for Jehovah Rapha. Jehovah Rapha, the Lord is your healer. I tell all my Muslim patients, why my the name is not, yes, not, I don't have a daughter who is Rapha, I don't have my wife, I don't have my second wife who is Rapha, but I know Jehovah Rapha. And when I pray for them, I proclaim Jehovah Rapha, manifest your power, Lord. And they begin to receive in faith. So friends, visualize with the eyes of faith. In faith confession, say by the stripes of Jesus I'm healed, and in faith action, do that which you couldn't do, and start giving thanks in faith. Do that which you couldn't do. You couldn't move your hand out. Maybe it was like a frozen shoulder. You cannot shake your shoulder, frozen shoulder. Now after you confess, after you visualize that Jehovah Rapha is your healer, and after you confess that by the stripes of Jesus I am healed, the next step you know is faith action. You are saying, thank you Jesus, thank you Jesus, thank you Jesus. And you are going to rotate your shoulder and the frozen shoulder becomes warm, no more frozen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, pray. take action. Faith
yes,
action.
Take action.
You begin to say, thank you, Jesus. I couldn't move this arm, but take now action. I thank you, Lord. Just an example. You do that in your situation. I don't know what is that you're struggling with. I want to tell you, you take the faith action, put faith into action, and start moving that. Do that which you couldn't do. Do that which you couldn't do. And start thanking Him by faith. Now, what are the circumstances about, we are fundraising and everything? Do you know that we have already, in our prayer meeting, we already started thanking God that this building is paid for before 2020. Yeah. We have been declaring, we have been saying, thank you, Lord, thank you, Jesus. We have been putting faith into action. We are doing it. And we are going to see the victory. In 2020, I will come here and I will announce that the building is paid for. Come on, give God the glory. By faith, let me take. Come on. Yeah. Let me take. Every time you clap, you are saying, yes, Lord. Amen. Clap with faith, alright? Now, if you are believing God, finally, if you are believing God for restoring your family relationship, if you are believing God for restoring your family relationship, you need to have faith vision. Knowing that God is the God who is the restorer.